Welcome, people. In the last video, we had started off with this parasitology, correct? We saw that they have divided parasitology into three parts. Protozoa, then you have microspora, Balanitidium coli, these are some parasites. Then you have helminths, these are also parasites. So three parts they have divided. There could be many more, but as of now, what we are seeing, they have divided into these three parts. Now, in protozoa parasites, we saw mainly entamoeba, trichomonas, which causes trichomonas vaginalis, then leishmania, trypanosoma, plasmodium. These are very important, guys. These five are very important. Then, fungi, microsporidium, they have asked in the exam. And they have also asked this Balanitidium coli. Okay. So just note that ringworm infection is nothing to do with worms. It is actually a fungal infection. Okay. Then coming to helminths, we have seen that in the last video, we came to know that there are three things under helminths: cestodes, trematodes and nematodes. Each of these we have to look at: cestodes, trematodes, nematodes. See here, cestodes, trematodes and nematodes. Cestodes, we have intestinal cestodes and others. Then we have trematodes, intestinal trematodes and others here. Then nematodes, we have intestinal nematodes and again other nematodes here. Let's look at the details. So cestodes, first of all, let's look at cestodes. Cestodes, please. Okay. So cestodes, we have intestinal cestodes. Important in these are Tinea solium, Tinea saginata. These are tapeworm. The diagram has been put here. You can put one lens and see nicely. You need a microscope, right, to see this. Yeah. Tapeworm it is. Tinea solium, Tinea saginata. This is a cestode. Then you have Hymenolepis. Hymenolepis. They have asked this in the exam. That's why it has been highlighted. Then other cestodes you have. Other cestodes you have cysticercosis, which is cysticercosis is a condition caused because of Tinea solium itself, but in the tissue, correct? Then you have echinococcus. Echinococcus. What is echinococcus? It's a cestode. It's a helminth. Okay. So please tell us all the important cestodes.
Tinea solium, Tinea saginata, Hymenolepis, cysticercosis, echinococcus.
Very good. Shall we move on to trematodes, guys? Trematodes, intestinal trematodes, they have not asked much. But this fasciolopsis, fasciola hepatica, liver fluke. One second. Anyways, in the exam, both they have asked blood trematodes, hepatic trematodes and lung trematodes. Blood trematodes, they have asked this cichistosoma, blood trematode, hepatic trematode, liver fluke. Hepatic means liver, right? Hepatic, that is fasciola hepatica, liver fluke, they have asked in the exam. Then lung trematodes, Paragonimus westermanni. Okay, where is this Paragonimus westermanni, guys? In the lung. It is a trematode, okay? Let's ask this boy, he will tell nicely. Where is Paragominus westermanni? Where is it? It is found in the lung. It's a lung trematode. It's a helminth. It's a parasite. Oh, very good, very good. Okay. Then coming to nematodes, let's move on to nematodes, guys. Nematodes, you have intestinal nematodes, small intestine, largest intestine. Small intestine, you can have the roundworm, that is Ascaris lumbricoides. Then you can have the hookworm, that is Ankylostoma duodenale. In large intestine, you can have Trichuris trichura, Enterobius vermicularis. Okay, these are in the they're going to be in the large intestine. Then coming to tissue nematodes, you will have filarial worm. Are you able to see this? This is the filarial worm. It causes elephantiasis. This is nothing but Wuchereria bancrofti. Just to write the spelling correctly in the exam, we are telling you this. There are two R's here. Wucher area, Bancrofti. This actually is spread by Culex mosquito, okay? Then you have Dracunculus medinensis, okay? That is also a nematode helminth parasite. Tell me this last word. Dracunculus. What is it? Dracunculus medinensis. Dracunculus medinensis is a nematode helminth parasite. Very good. Nematode helminth parasite. Very good, guys. So we have covered classification of helminths based on the habitat. Okay, we have looked at all the terms which are important for the exam. So you should be able to correctly identify from which place are they talking at least, okay? In parasitology, hopefully from now, you will be able to say exactly from where are people in parasitology and what exactly is happening. Okay, so please revise this video again if you have time. See you. Bye-bye for now. Meet you in the next video, guys. Bye-bye.